see on the video screen. So she's turning the nose up right now. So what they do is they put the food in that colored bucket, and then as the zoo ops person pulls himself across the top of the water, you'll see there's a rope there. They pull themselves across the water with one hand. The other hand, they're pulling that bucket in front of the mouth of the whale sharks. That's pretty tricky. Pull with one hand, pull with the other. And of course, they have a life jacket for the other rats and the other whale sharks. I would say it's bumper cars, but they have a life jacket for that. So what they do is they'll take them back and forth across the top. But if you look all the way to the right underwater, we don't see this one on the video screen. It's in the whale shark, so you're in turn. They get a big turn, so I turn the whale on that battleship. That's Alice, one of our females. And back in the other direction. And you can just barely see at the top of the corner of the video screen, that's the route that's leading Alice that we just seen. So in the middle, we have two people still waiting for the whale sharks. Maybe they're not hungry this morning. I don't know. They do have a whale-sized appetite. But, we got one coming up here. Looks like on the screen, if you're looking underwater, this is to the left of center. This is Tuoka, one of our male whale sharks. So look at the mouth on the whale shark. Really easy to see underwater. You can imagine, well, he fixed his bucket there. That mouth on an adult full-size whale shark can get to be about 4 feet across. So you can see all the way to the left. It's the same whale shark that's on the far left of the video screen. You see them to water they are taking in. So you can imagine on a full-grown whale shark how much water. Now in front of us, this is Trixie. She can't find her raft. It's out that way. Trixie, by the way, if you weren't with us earlier, Trixie is our largest of our four whale sharks. They do range between 21 and 27 feet in length. They are still growing. In fact, we wouldn't be surprised if our whale sharks got to be half the length of our window here. This window is about 63 feet across. So these whale sharks coming out to be about 30, 35, 40 feet. So we got one all the way to the left, and we got one all the way to the right. Look at those gill slits open up on the side of the head when we make that turn. That's all the water coming out, minus the food. Whale sharks are what we call filter feeders. So they suck in all this water with the food, filter it out, swallow it, and then the remaining water comes out the gill slits. Now, if you're wondering what's going on at the top left of our window here, we can't see. There's a zoo ops person on a stand that's over there about waist high, and they're feeding a bunch of our rays and smaller fish up the top left. So that's what all that activity is. All right, we've got a raft that's found at Tuoka, our male whale shark. That's the one on the video screen. Again, looking under the water to the left of center, coming at us. So look at all that water that's being sucked in. And you notice there's a lot of little fish swimming alongside trying to get some of the scraps. And occasionally, they might get in front of the whale shark and they might get sucked in. But we learned earlier, they can't swallow those fish, they'll throw it in. It's only the size of the worse, so they can't swallow those fish. So usually the fish will quickly dart out of the mouth of the whale shark, or they could actually go out their gill slits.